love, love, love is so loving. Love is the answer to all our woes. Just embrace the love heart before you. Focus on the love heart. Love and light, people. Please just...
I have a...
Love and light, people.
It's martial arts practice. Yeah.
Love and light, people. Just focus on the love, Jones.
Wait, this way? All right. Wait. No. Hate. 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 Satanicus no liking. Hate. What's going on over here? Hate. Hate. Satanicus. I'm poking the other way. What the fuck? What's going on over here? Hate. Hate. Satanicus no like.
Love, brother. Love. Just fill yourself with the love, brother. Love and light.
Darkness and mayhem. Darkness and mayhem. Love and light. Oh. I think I'm falling in love with you, babe.
You people, right? Are so... I don't know. It's like...
Look around you.
You know...
Look at me. Take time to make time, make time to be there.
And James party, whatever.
Look around.
Whatever, dude. Look around.
Be apart.
Be apart. We're all looking for the same thing anyway, you know. A real man, right? Looks out for the safety and the honor of a real woman, right? And a real woman looks out for the safety and the honor of a real man. Really simple. But even beyond that, a woman, a real woman, doesn't just, a real, real woman doesn't just look for the safety and the honor and the justice of other women or whatever man she may be into. A real woman will look after, you know, the safety, the honor, the justice, the purity, the truth of all, male and female. Same goes for a real man. A lot of things have been going on for the longest time in this world's evolutionary progress. There on the dance floor making me want you somehow. But lady, I think it's only fair I should say that. Thinking that I don't want you, cause maybe I do. So, like, people think it's just the Bible that people have tampered with? The Vedas too? Everywhere. Tampered all across the board. The Quran everywhere. Tampered. The Vedas are so older, and so they've been tampered with even more. So that's why, and Christians don't get all excited when you hear this. That's why, because you don't have a copyright on the Holy Spirit, okay? That's why the Holy Spirit is the comforter. Because the Holy Spirit dwells within everyone as their true spirit, man. As their true, you know, as that spark of divine Godhead. Call it Paramatma, call it what you will. I use Sanskrit, and then people, you know, I have enough friends from India, and they're beautiful, I love them. But I love them because of who they are, not because of where they come from. The same way, anyone, you can come from Kentucky, you can come from, you know, anywhere, Timbuktu, Madagascar, anywhere, and I will love you. I'm intense, but I'm true, I'm real. So it's like I was giving a class today on the Srimad Devi Bhagavatam, which is supposedly about glorifying the goddess, and it does, but even there you see like distortions, you see the mad patriarchal disease coming up. So I guess two people should know, if you don't know already, I'm here to let you know, because I'm not afraid to speak about certain matters that I've meditated on, more than meditated on, for too long to even mention, right? And so I'm giving this class and I'm reading from the Srimad Devi Bhagavatam, and then I noticed something that I've noticed in a while, but I just went with it and I started being touched by the spirit, you see? Because the spirit, that true spirit, that most sacred spirit, is, you can say, is like Ganesh. Now don't say, he said the Holy Spirit is Ganesh. Relax. Just making a comparison. Ganesh has these big ears, right? The elephant god with the elephant head. He has these big ears. And they are elephant ears. And they are compared to winnowing baskets. Winnowing baskets. The type of basket that you get together and you separate, you shake, and you separate the wheat from the chaff, you see? And so his ears, his listening capacity are compared to like winnowing baskets, separating the true from the false, the good from the bad. Huh? And Ganesh is a symbol, his head is a symbol of the macrocosm of the universe, the universal consciousness, you see? And so, dwelling within the consciousness of a microcosmic being, which that's why the bottom half is the human body. And so we have to see these symbolisms and understand what they mean, rather than just blindly worship without knowing what you are really focusing on. We have a lot to do, we have a lot to learn, and a lot of ways to grow. So, taking shelter of the Holy Spirit is like that. Paramatma is like that. So a lot of people, they like to talk about Bhagavan, or Yashua, or some other personality of Godhead. And they focus so much on the personality of Godhead, but even Krishna says in one of the writings ascribed to him, he says, in the Bhagavad Gita, he says, those who call themselves my direct devotees are not my devotees. Those who are the devotees of the devotees of the devotees of my devotees, those who are the servants of the servants, the loving servants of my devotees, who see me and them so far apart, those are the ones, those are the ones who I treasure, who I give myself to. And so these winnowing ears, these discriminating ears, the inner ear, the inner hearing sense, the subtle hearing sense, which is called the tanmatra, but that's another thing, I don't want to confuse you, but basically, you have the capacity is all I'm saying. So in it, Vyasa, just because a book, no matter how sacred it's considered, says that someone said this and someone said that, that's not necessarily a fact. There's many things that have been tampered. So Vyasa was talking about, according to this translation, or even, even if it's not a translation, according to this version, Vyasa is talking about how if you don't have a son, then you will not go to heaven, you will go to a hellish place. I don't agree with that. And I noticed that throughout the whole thing, it's about son, 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 no daughter, 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 because daughter, in certain cultures, many cultures, have been considered a commodity, an object, trade. This is not nice, my friends, and there is nothing of the pure love of Godhead in this. This is what I'm saying. And this is the truth, whether you like it or not. Hare Krishna. Because Hare is the goddess, more than just the energy of the Lord. It's the goddess. She is the Lord personification, as well as Krishna is. And this Krishna and Radha dwell within each and every one of us, people. Within each and every one of us. You know? I just wanted to say that. I just also want to say, and those people who freak out, when I freak out, whatever, that's fine. You know? You'd have to walk more than a mile in my shoes to understand where I'm coming from. Most of you don't. Some of you do. But most of you won't get where I'm coming from, where I'm trying to come from, which seems like I'm light years away sometimes. What I'm trying to say, what I'm trying to share, it seems like most will only get it long after I leave, whenever that is. Huh? But some of you get it now. Like some of you saw the humor and the truth, in the last video I did. Most of you won't. You know? Okay. Hare Krishna. Om Namah Shivaya, because I don't want to offend this group or that group. Ma ferefuno batala. What is that? How about this one? Lucifer love.